안녕하세요, 여러분. 안녕하세요, 엘리하. 엘리하, is that right? 반갑습니다. I'm doing at 3 p.m. in Korean time for the first time, I think, on a weekday. But still, I can see many of you, and thank you for coming. 안녕하세요, 알리나. 잘 지내셨나요? It should be like early morning. Oh, 7 a.m. in the morning. Thank you. I just woke up. Thank you for joining. Today, we're gonna talk about the vocabulary, like words and phrases you might need to know in an airport in South Korea. Alina says 7 a.m. and Nashville is midnight. Oh, thank you. And 안녕하세요, 동방민주. Thank you for coming. Okay, let's go on. Vocabulary first. So let's talk about the words you might need to know in an airport in South Korea. And probably there are many signs. All the signs are in English and some other language as well. But still, you might need some help from stranger. In most Korean, not every Korean can speak English. So maybe it'd be better to know some words. So let's go. Thank you, Tahir. Good day and have a nice day to you all. And okay, let's go on. Oops. How to say passport? Okay. Do you guys know how to say passport in Korean? Annyeonghaseyo, 여러분. Passport. How to say passport in Korean? 제가 한번 써볼게요. 여 권 여 권 Owen says right, and 동방민주 여관 means it's more like a motel. 여관 is kind of like motel. 여권 is the correct spelling, and it pronounced like 여권. Even though it spells like 여권, its actual pronunciation is more like 여권. Like everyone, it's pretty safe to say everyone pronounce it like 여권. 여권. And it spells like 여권. That means passport. Hi, Rosie. So, can you make any sentence using 여권? Like, okay, let's say, can I see your passport? Do you know how to say, like, when some officer says, can I see your passport? Do you guys know how to say that in Korean? Can I see, or just, can you show me your passport? Can you show me your passport? In Korean, it's usually, it's 여, again, 여권. 좀. 좀 doesn't really mean anything, but it makes it a little more polite when you use 좀. 여권 좀 보여 주시겠어요? 여권 좀 보여주시겠어요? If someone says 여권 좀 보여주시겠어요? It means, can you show me your passport? So, yes. That's how to say, can you show me your passport? 여권 좀 보여주세요. That's also fine. 여권 좀 보여주세요. Please, can I, 여권 좀 보여주세요 means please show me your passport. 네, 여권을 보여주실래요? Would you show me your passport? Something like that. 여권이 주세요. It sounds a little weird. 여권이 주세요. Or 여권 주세요. Just 여권 주세요. Or if you wanna use some particle, then 여권을. 여권을 주세요. 여권을 주세요. 여권을 주세요. But you can just, you know, drop that particle. Just 여권 주세요. It doesn't really sound polite though. 여권 주세요. You can say that. The officer can say that. It's not really rude or anything like that. But still, 여권 좀 보여주시겠어요? It's more common. 여권 보여주세요. 여권 좀 보여주세요. Yeah, those two are common way to say those two. And how to say 여권? I forgot the passport. I forgot to bring it. How can you say that in Korean? 여권을? 여권? I forgot the passport. Oops. Let's do this. Can you say 여권을? I forgot the passport. 여권을 놓고 왔어요. 여권을 망했다. 망했다. I'm not sure what that means. 여권을 놓고 왔어요. That means 여권을 I didn't carry. Like I didn't bring the passport. 여권을 잊어버렸어요. That's I forgot the passport. You can say that too. That's perfect. And another way is 여권을 깜빡했어요. 여권을 깜빡했어요. Let me just do this way. 여권을 여권 을. You can put 을 or you can drop it. 여권 여권을 double 기억 쌍기억 깜 and double 비읍 but has 어요 여권은 깜빡했어요. That means it slipped my mind to bring the passport. 깜빡하다 is like slip one's mind. So 깜빡했어요. 여권을 잊어버렸어요. Also fine. I forgot about the passport. 여권을 잊어버렸어요. Or 여권을 깜빡했어요. And 여권을 놓고 왔어요. That's also fine. I'm not carrying. I leave it in my home, in my place. 여권을 놓고 왔어요. And you guys doing really great about it. So yeah, 여권 means passport. And let's go on. And how to say boarding pass in Korean? You guys know? How to say boarding pass? I can wait and maybe it takes some time to type in Korean, I guess. boarding pass. Maybe it's hard. 탑승권. Okay. Boarding pass. Yeah, that's good. Boarding pass. Oh, you don't know, Alina? Okay, it's okay. 탑승권, boarding pass is also fine. I'll show you. Boarding pass in Korean is 탑 승, 권, 탑승, 권, 탑승권. 탑승 means boarding, boarding. And 권 is like a right, it's a certificate or proof of right to do something. And 탑승권 is like just boarding pass. So 탑승권. And then, can you show me your boarding pass? How do you say that in Korean? Can you show me your boarding pass? Last time you wrote, can you show me your passport? And this time, can you show me your boarding pass? It'll be easy, I think. Good afternoon, Nabila. 탑승권, 탑승권. That's boarding pass. So, 탑승 좀 보여주시겠어요? 탑승권. Without 권, it's kind of weird. So, 탑승권. Like 동방민주 says, 탑승권을 주세요. Give me your boarding pass. Teacher, when do we use and how to distinguish 를 and 는, 이가? If you're asking me about like when to use between 를 and 을, I think it's easy and I think you probably know, but still I have to explain that. You say 를 after a vowel and you say 을 after a consonant. But if you're asking me that when to use difference between 은가, 은는 and 이가, then that's really tough and that's really long to explain. All I can say for now is like I made a video about that, so please watch that video. It's like the video is called Main Differences Between 은는 and 이가. 탑승권을 보여주세요. That's perfect. And 탑승권을 좀 보여주시겠어요? That's also perfect. Hi teacher, thank you for make this live at this hour. I always miss your lives because I'm in work hours. You're welcome. You're welcome. Gisri? I'm not sure how to pronounce your account name, but you're welcome. 탑승권 보여주시겠어요? Yeah, that's perfect. That's perfect, yes. 탑승권 보여주세요. 보여주시겠어요? Okay, so far, so good. Then, let me see. Do you know how to say departure? Departure. Departure. Let's hold on, please. Some of you may don't know, but 가다, 가다 is like just go, to go, and departure. 출발, yeah, 출발. 출발 means departure. 출발, 출발 also means start as a noun, and 출발하다 is a verb for start. But departure, 출발 also means departure. And how to say arrival in Korean? 출발하기, 출발하기. 출발하기 is kind of like a noun, but 출발 itself is perfect. 출발 and arrival means 도착. 출발 and 도착. 출발 means departure and 도착. 도착. 출발 and 도착. I want to learn Korean by myself. What should I start with? I've studied the alphabet already. Yeah, when you're learning Korean, alphabet is one of the easiest point, easiest thing. But if other than that, it may really complicated and really it might be really hard. I think starting the basic things, like just know, learn about the basic stuff, like I am a student, or starting with the basic one first. That's all I can say. And getting used to the pronunciation. Yeah, I mean, depends on what language you're getting used to. The Korean pronunciation is re it can be really, really hard, so it also helps, I think. Oh, thank you, Virginia Molina. Thank you. Finally, in a live chat. Nice to see you, Petrenko. It sounds like a Ukrainian name to me. I'm not sure about that though. 지금 자러 가야 되는데 좋은 하루 되세요. Oh, thank you, Rachel, and have a good sleep, Rachel. 도착 means arrival. So, yeah, 도착 means arrival. And do you guys know how to say taking off and landing? Taking off and landing. Oh, that's a Ukrainian name. Nice to see you on the live during the live streaming. Thank you. Yulia. Nice to see you, Yulia. So, how to say taking off and landing? Anybody knows in Korean? Biengi, 올리다 and 내리다. That's not right. 비행기 올리다 내리다. No, 이륙. 이륙 means taking off. 이륙, taking off. Oh, thank you again, Virginia. Thank you. Thank you for your super chat, Virginia. And our names are difficult. Our names. Where do you live, can I ask? And can you write that in Korean spelling as well? You don't have to, but can I ask? Go Billy has an excellent curriculum. So does talk to me in Korean. That's true. Something I find hard is the syllable thing. Haven't searched about it. So you have a nice video about that. Basic Korean one, maybe. That's one of the easy one. But after that, basic Korean two can be really hard for you. So maybe basic Korean one. Yeah, basic Korean 01. That's the title that I made, and you may watch that video if you haven't. And 착륙 means landing, like 이륙, taking off, 착륙 is landing. 이륙, 착륙. And looks like 동방민주 knows many Korean words. Oh, letter games is on Sunday. I'm trying to do that every Sunday. Not today. Today is just like some vocabulary and some like making sentence practice. So sorry about that. Hello, I'm a huge fan of your videos and way of teaching. Thank you. Thank you for saying that, and you're welcome. Halil Zeybek. You're welcome. Okay, so 출발. So Can you say when does the plane start? Like departure. When? What time? The plane departure in Korean. Suddenly my English is, I'm not sure about that, but can you say what time is the departure time of your plane? Can you write that in Korean? Departure means 출발. So okay, 비행기 means airplane. You can just use 비행기. 출발 means departure, like departure. Kind of like taking off, time of taking off. Maybe it's really hard. So usually, let's see. Oops. Okay, I just write something in Korean. 비행기. 비행기 means airplane. And 몇? 몇 is like what number? What number? But 몇 시 means what time? 비행기 몇 시? You can put 에. 비행기 몇 시에? Or 비행기 몇 시? 출발해. Like 출발해 or 출발해요. It depends on the situation. 비행기 몇 시 출발해요? 비행기 몇 시 출발해요? It's like 비행기 출발 시간이 어떻게 돼요? You can say like that. 언제 출발이에요? You can say like that. When is the what time? When is the departure? 언제 출발이에요? Or 언제 출발해요? It's fine. 언제 출발해요? 비행기는 출발 언제예요? 비행기는 언제 출발해요? It's more natural. 비행기는 언제 출발해요? 비행기 언제 출발이에요? Or 비행기 몇 시? What time? 비행기 몇 시에 출발해요? 비행기 몇 시에 출발해요? 예. 비행기 출발은 몇 시예요? 비행기 출발은 몇 시예요? 비행기 출발은 몇 시예요? You can say like that. It's not wrong. Grammatically, it's not wrong at all, but not 100% natural. I feel like that. 비행기 출발은 몇 시예요? But you can say like that, I guess. Yeah, nothing wrong about that. 비행기 출발은 몇 시예요? 언제 출발은이에요? That sounds a little weird to me. 언제 출발해요? 언제 출발해요? You can say like that. 언제 출발해요? When is the departure? My English is not very good too, but I appreciate your effort for teach me. You're welcome, Gisri. Okay, so then you can say 비행기. Okay, when I say 비행기 몇 시 도착이에요? Or 도착해요. 도착해요 or 도착이에요. 비행기 몇 시 도착이에요? Then you can tell what it means, right? 비행기 몇 시에 도착해요? 비행기 몇 시 도착이에요? It's like what time is the arrival? So, oops. Let me see. At what time depart the airplane? When's the arrival? Arrival is 도착. 비행기 도착 언제예요? Yeah, that's right. And at what time depart the airplane? At what time depart the airplane? 몇 시에 비행기 출발해요? Yeah, 몇 시에 비행기 출발해요? That's what it means. Okay, so let's go on. So, okay, do you know how to say airline company in Korean? Airline company, just airlines. airline company. Do you know how to say that in Korean? Airlines or airline company. Anida means no. What time is a plane arrival? Yeah, 비행기 도착 시간 몇 시예요? That's right. 공항. 공항 means airport. I should have started with 공항. 공항 means airport. Owen is correct. 항공사. 항공사. That's okay. 항공사. Airport. Company. And yeah, airport company in general is 항공사. And if you wanna say about the specific airline, specific company, airline company, then you usually drop 사, like, you know, 대한항공, 아시아나항공, or like United 항공, something like that, Northwest 항공. In that case, you normally drop 사, just airlines. But just airline company in general is 항공사, for your information. And now, domestic line. How do you say domestic line? 공기 호수. That's looks like Google Translate. I'm not sure. Let me check. looks like Google Translate. 공기 호수. Where is it? A 공기 호스. 공기 is like just air, and horse is like when you watering some on your lawn, you connect horse to your tap, and you know that kind of thing is horse. Horse, I think it's horse in English. So, 항공사 means airlines, airline company. This airport airplane stuff is difficult. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, I understand it's not really for beginner level. Is it bad if we talk with an accent? I mean, should I really focus on pronunciation? Accent. I'll say accent is not that matters. Yeah, but when you learning Korean, it's more of a pronunciation, I think. Okay, 국내선, or like Dongbang Minju said 국내선, that's domestic line, 국내선. 국내선, like 국내. 국, the 국. This 국 is the Sino-Korean, like Chinese character that means country, and 내 means inside. So inside country line. That's 국내선, domestic line. And everybody wrote 국제선 this time. 미안해요, 선생님. I need to go to university. It was a pleasure for me to be on your live. You are the best. Thank you, Alina, and see you again. Thank you for coming. And you don't have to be sorry about it at all. I understand that you might be busy. Like not, it's not that everyone is not busier. So I understand that. Don't be sorry about that. And thank you, Jess. I like that you correct our sentences to be natural, not just grammatically okay. And thank you. Thank you for liking my lessons. Thank you. 예, 또 만나요, 알리나. And where was I? Okay. 국내선. We talked about 국내선. Now, international line. cook something fun. Like what something? Cook something fun. Cook. Can you write the whole thing? Cook something fun. International line. Yeah, international line. When are the lives? I'm planning on picking up Korean again. And I remember your videos helped me a lot when I started. Thank you. I'm glad it was helpful. Our lives are usually Sunday morning, 11 a.m. Korean time. Most of the Sunday, 11, I mean, almost every Sunday at 11 in the morning in Korean time. And yeah, but I try to do more often, so I'm not sure, but I cannot really say about the other days, but I'm trying to do the live streaming more often. And thank you for asking. And Sorta Christina, cook where? Okay, without the line, 국내 and 국외. The opposite of 국내 is 국외. But when you say about 국, the international line, that's different this time. And like 동방민주 says, 국제선 is the correct one in this case. 국제선. 국제선 means international line. 선생님, 아니요 하고 아니에요. 뭐가 달라요? Last time or 2 weeks earlier, there was the same question. 아니요. 아니에요. 아니에요. I made an answer back then, but I forgot how to answer that. 아니요. 아니요 is like just no, it's not. And 아니에요. It's like when someone says a real long explanation, long something, and if that's not correct, you can say 아니에요. Or sometimes it can be like no, it's not that. Or sometimes it's like polite way to say you're welcome. Sometimes it can be like you're welcome. 아니에요. 아니요 means no, that's not right. And 아니에요. It's very similar though. Not sure how to say that. Gukjaesun, what means 제? 국제선. 국제. Okay, 국외 is like outside country. 국외. And 외국 is a foreign country. And 국제 is like just international. International. Like international. The connection between the countries. That's 국제. 안녕하세요, 무하마드. No, we're supposed to. No, it is not. 아니요, 아니에요. 아니요 is just no. 아니요 means simply no. 아니요. 아니에요. That's not really the case. Or sometimes it can be like, you're welcome. Now, like, you're welcome. Kind of like that. 네, okay, so 국내선 and 국제선. Okay, then what else? Okay. Also, this time I'm showing some words together, like combination of words together. It can be hard for beginners. If you're a beginner, it can be really hard, but just for your information. 액체. You guys know what 액체 means? 액체. 액체. You're welcome, Hoang. 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 Fun. 액체. Okay, I just. 액체 means liquid. Liquid. And 액체류 is like liquid kind. Liquid kind. Kind. Liquid kind. 액체류. 액체 means, yeah, 액체 means liquid, and 액체류 means kind of like liquid kind. And 반입. 반입 means carrying inside, like carrying inside. Carrying inside. 액체류, 반입, and 금지. 금지. 금지 means banned or prohibited. So, you know what it means, right? 액체류, like, it's kind of like no liquid. No liquid inside, maybe. Kind of like that. 액체 and 액체류. Hello, sir. It's been a long time. 보고 싶어요. I'm doing my best now. Thank you, Moon Fitri. Moon Fitri. Thank you. Forbidden. Yeah, forbidden. Yeah, right. Forbidden, prohibited, and banned. That's, 금지 means those words. So, 액체류, 반입, 금지. Like, carrying inside the liquid is prohibited. So, okay, now, this time. Oops, oh, how to do that? Then, 반입, 금지, 물품. 반입, 금지, 물품. Can you guys guess what it means? I'm interested in Korean language. I just watching your live. I can't. I'm sorry about that. It's not really easy for beginners. I'm sorry about that. Maybe it's really hard for you guys. How to say I'm okay? I'm okay. 괜찮아요. Like, oh, I'm okay. Don't worry. I'm okay. Then just 괜찮아요. Okay. I'll show you the spelling. 괜. Maybe I just write, type that, but still. 괜찮아요. You don't have to pronounce that H sound. Like, you don't have to pronounce this H sound. You don't have to pronounce that one. Just 괜찮아요. 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 That's I'm okay. Mulpum. Mul means water, but mulpum is just totally different meaning. Not water. Mulpum is more like item or items. So, banned items, forbidden items, like forbidden, prohibited items. So it can be like lighter, liquid, you know, those kind of things, or some weapons. Yeah, that kind of thing. In this case, 반입, 금지, 물품. And that's what it means. 반입, 금지, 물품. Okay, now, okay. 편도 and 왕복. 편, okay, just go faster. 편도. 편도 is like one way, and 왕 It's like round trip. One way and round trip. Water is prohibited. I think so. Because it can be some kind of chemical weapon can be disguised as a pretend to be water. I think that's why water is forbidden. Carrying inside stuff forbidden. 반입 금지 물품. It's not easy, but it's my fault. I'm not watching your videos more frequently. You don't have to be like, it's not your fault. I mean, you take more time to study, you get better. So, restricted item. That's looks great. 반입 금지 물품. Restricted item. That's perfect. How to say in hostress? Hostress? Let's check what hostress means. Hostress. Hostress? Can't find any hostress. Hostress. I can't find that word in my dictionary here. Not sure about that. Sorry about that, 동방민주. 편도, 왕복. 앙복, 왕복. It's 왕복. Could you tell us what each 한자 means in 편도 and 왕복? 편. 편. 편 is like side. Side. Like 내 편, 네 편. My side, your side. That kind of 편. 도 is like road, way, like sideways, like one or one direction. It can be like one direction way. 편 is like side or direction. It can be like direction, sort of. So just one way. That's one way. And 왕복, 왕복. I'm not sure about the 한자. The sign of the Chinese characters about 왕복. 왕복. Let me check. Oops. 왕복. 복 is like. Oh, 왕복 is like just go and come, looks like. Come and go. Go and come. Yeah. So that's round trip. Oh, 물품. 물품 is just item. Item. Even though there is 물, which means water, but 물품 is just totally different word. Not water or anything like that. 물품. Oh, stewardess. Stewardess. To say stewardess, you can say just stewardess. It's just an English word, stewardess. Or you can say air crew. 승무원. Air crew. 승무원. The stewardess or 승무원. And flight attendant. Flight 탑승객. Like 탑승. 탑승 is like boarding. And 탑승객. Flight attendant. It can be just ship attendant or just anything. 탑승객. 탑승객. Or just you can drop 탑. 승객. 승객 is like passengers. Passengers. Or like flight attendant. Yeah, it can be like that. Do I see any question? Oh, One Direction is love. Hostess. 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 Oh, let's check hostess. There's an no R there. What's this? I think you mean the 승무원, aircrew, right? 승무원, that's right. Konglish strikes again. do you mean the stewardess? Stewardess. You're welcome, Dan. It's like come to my side or the people near me. 편도. 편도 is like just one direction. 편도, 편도. That's all I can say for now. Hi, teacher. I didn't know there was class. I'm late. Oh, because I usually don't do this on Sunday, but I'm just trying to do this on Thursday in Korean time. I'm trying to do it more often. Anyway, okay, let's practice again. Let's imagine you're at the airport and maybe you need some help from strangers, like Korean stranger. What would it be? What kind of situation can you can imagine? Like, what kind of situation? Can I ask about that? Just imagine you're in an airport in Korea and there's a situation you may need some help from strangers. What would it be? At what time, teacher? Oh, on Sunday, it's 11 a.m. in Korean time. And the other days, not regularly. What time is in Korea now? It's 3:47 in the afternoon, Thursday. Where is baggage claim? Oh, baggage claim. Baggage is 수하물 찾는 곳. 수함을 찾는 곳. Okay. On the sign, you can see like 수함을 찾는 곳. 수하물 찾는 곳. 찾다 is like to find. It's a verb. 찾다. But it's 찾는 곳. 찾는 곳. 곳. 곳 is like area or place. 수함을 찾는 곳. Or you may see this sign on a sign, but if you want to ask that to a people, the Korean people, then you normally say 짐. 짐, like 미음 받침. 짐 찾는, oops, not 니은, 찾는 는 곳. 짐 찾는 곳. 짐 찾는 곳 어디 있어요? 어디 있어요? Oops. 짐 찾는 곳 어디 있어요? Or you can say it, 수함을 찾는 곳 어디 있어요? You can ask that way too. And if you want, if on the sign like then you can see 수함을 찾는 곳. 수함을 찾는 곳, 짐 찾는 곳 means the same. 수함을 is baggage. Yeah, baggage. How do I check in? How do I check in? Check in. Check in 어떻게 해요? Check in. Like check. Just check in. How do I check in? How do I check in? 어떻게 해요? Like 어떻게 is like how. So check in 어떻게 해요? Or check in 어디서? It's like where. 어디, you can optionally put 에, 어디에서, or just 어디서. Check in 어디서 해요? Where do I check in? Check in 어떻게 해요? How do I check in? Check in 어디서 해요? Where do I check in? Oh, see you again, Muhammad. If talk to the counter staff, request it for the window seat or corridor seat. What is 찾는? 찾는 is like derived from the verb 찾다, which means to find. It's a past question, I think. 찾는 is derived from 찾다, which means to find. That's the answer. And I forgot the question. Oh, the seat or corridor seat. Window seat or corridor seat. I forgot about that. Okay. That was one of the on the list. You know. 좌석 means seat. 좌석 means seat. Or 자리. 자리 also means it can be like seat. 자리 or place. It can be like place too. 복도 means corridor or like narrow and long straight passage is 복도. Usually inside the machine or building, 복도. 복도 쪽. Oops. 복도 side. 복도. 복도 쪽. 자리. Or 좌석. Both are fine. It's like aisle seat or corridor seat. Or 창가. 창가 쪽. 창가 자리. Or 창가 쪽 자리. No. Sorry about that. 창가 means window. 복도 쪽 자리. 아, 통로. I was confused. 통로. 통로 is like passage. Passage? 통로. Passing through way. Like a passage. Yeah, I think so. 통로. Let's check. 통로. Passage. Yeah, passage. 통로 means passage. So, either 통로 쪽 자리, 복도 쪽 자리, those two means aisle seat or corridor seat. And 창가 쪽 자리. 창 means window. So 창가, like around window. 창가 쪽 자리. It's like window seat. 창 means window. 창 means window. So, yeah, that's it. Let's see. 화장실 어디예요? 화장실 어디예요? Oh, that's Korean. 화장실 어디요? Where is the restroom? 화장실 어디예요? Oh, 화장실 어디에 있어요? Where is the restroom? 시트 near to the window. 야, 창가 쪽 자리. Sit near to the window. How do I get to the lost and found department? Oh. Lost and found. Lost and found. I forgot the word. 유실물. 유실물. Lost and found. 유실물. Let's make it blank. 유실물. 물 is like Chinese character for thing, stuff. 유실물. 예, lost property. 유실물 찾는 곳. 유실물 찾는 곳 어디 있어요? 유실물 어디서 찾을 수 있어요? 야, yeah. 유실물 어디서 찾을 없다. 찾 is 지읒. 찾을 수 있나요? Or 있어요? 유실물 어디서 찾을 수 있어요? 유실물 어디서 찾을 수 있어요? How do I get to the lost and found department? 유실물 보관소. Lost and found department is like 유실물 보관소. 보관 is like storage or something like that. So 유실물 보관소 is like lost and found department. Yeah, so yeah, that's it for that. And what else? Where can I take a taxi? 택시 어디에서 잡아요? 택시. Taxi 어디서 or 어디에서? 어디에서 or 어디서? Just 어디서? To catch a taxi. It's like to catch a taxi. Literally, to catch a taxi. So, 택시를 잡다. To catch a taxi. And 택시 어디서 잡아요? Or you can add 택시를. 택시를 어디서 잡아요? But you can just drop 를 there. 택시 어디서 잡아요? Where can I take a taxi? How to rent a car in Korea? How to rent a car? Do you mean the sentence? 어떻게 한국에서 어떻게 차를 렌트할 수 있어요? I just write down that in the sentence. How do I 한국에서 한국 in Korea 렌트카 차를 어떻게 빌릴 수 있어요? 차 means car. 어떻게 how 어떻게 렌트 빌리다 to rent 렌트 할 수 있어요? 네, 한국에서 차를 어떻게 렌트할 수 있어요? How do I rent a car in Korea? Like, if you ask me how, then maybe you can see a sign, rent a car, like car renting, rent a car, that's car renting. So if you see that sign, then maybe there's a car renting company is inside the building. Or if you wanna ask where can I rent a car, then just ask someone. 차 어떻게 렌트할 수 있어요? 차를 or 차를 어떻게 렌트할 수 있어요? You can ask that sentence. 차를 어떻게 렌트할 수 있어요? Oh, 안녕하세요, 진뚜. 오랜만입니다, 진뚜. You're welcome, Gisri. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing your right account name right. 떠날 때 식당에서 무엇을 말합니까? You enjoy the meal, and when you leave the eating place, then you can say 잘 먹었어요. 잘 먹었어요. When you leave the eating place. When you leave the just 잘 like either 먹었어요 or 먹었습니다. 잘 먹었습니다. Or 잘 먹었어요. It's like ate well, ate nicely. I enjoyed your meal. I enjoyed your dish. That's what it means. And when you say that to the eating place, the workers, then they like that. And that's the most common way to say I ate well when you leave the restaurant or anything like that. 잘 먹었어요. 잘 먹었습니다. 카 is yeah 카 렌트 카카 is just a English word. English like Korean spelling. And 카 렌트 카 when you say 렌트 카 this car is just simply car. Car, so not really a Korean word, but you know, rent a car. It's a car renting. Where is it? Where is our question? Okay. And okay, so oh, I missed the plane. How do you say that? I missed the plane. I missed the plane. 비행기를 I'll just do it quickly. 비행기를 놓쳤어요. 비행기를 Oops. 비행기를 비행기 or you can drop 르 but anyway 비행기를 놓쳤어요. It's like 놓치다 is like you hold it and you lose it from your hand. Literally that's what it means. But when you say 비행 you missed the plane, then you can say 비행기를 놓쳤어요. 비행기를 놓쳤어요. 보고 싶다, miss. Miss can be translated in many ways. Hello, I love this. Thank you very much. You're welcome. I'm not sure how to pronounce your name. It looks like a Thailand alphabet. 비행기를 놓쳤어요. I missed the plane. And oh, can you say where is the information desk? Where is the information desk? How do you say that in Korean? Where is the information desk? Information desk. Maybe you are typing right now, but I just write it anyway. 안내 데스크. 안내 데스크. 어디? Oops. 어디 있어요? 안내 데스크. Like information desk is 안내 데스크. 어디에 아내가 있다. 아내. 아내. 안내. And 아내 means different. 아내. Okay, 아내. 아내 means wife. 예, 아내 means wife. And 안내. It's like two names in a row. 안내. Like in nature, like on number. 안내. Then you have to. You need a 니은 받침. 안내 means information. Oops. 아. Information. There are two kinds of information. One is like 안내, and the other one is 정보. 정보. 정보 also means information, but the difference is that 정보 is like information about a news or information about your opponent. That kind of information is 정보. In information like how to do it or where how to use it or where to go, that kind of information is like 안내, like for inquiry, kind of like that. How to do that, asking, you know, that kind of information is 안내, and 정보 is another information just for your information. 혹시 안내 데스크 어디에 있나요? Oh, that's perfect Korean. 혹시 is like perhaps or like just politely saying, asking like where or kind of like that. 혹시 안내 데스크 어디에 있나요? 있나요 or 있어요? Both are fine. If you ask the difference between 있나요 and 있어요, 어디 있어요 and 어디 있나요? I cannot say the difference. Like the difference is really small. You can almost ignore the differences. Okay, and 안내 데스크 어디 있어요? That's or where is the information desk? Okay. I mean, okay, this, if you have a question, I mean, the today's session is about to end, and you can freely ask anything if you have a question. 나요 is always a question. Like, Owen asked me, 나요 is always a question. 나요? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, 나요? Yes, that's a question, always. When you see 니은 at the end of a sentence, like 니은, 나요, 했냐, 했니, 했나, 했는가, mostly it's a question. Do you have Korean book suggestion for intermediate learner? I'm sorry about that. I don't have any suggestions. Intermediate learners. Sorry about that. And thank you, Jess. I'm glad you learned a lot. Maybe I'll end the session in 5 minutes, so you can ask me anything if you have a question or if anything about the airport thing or just the question in general, anything would be fine. Do you know how to say? Can you talk a little slowly, a little slower? I have a question. Korean grammar for speaking is very good. Korean grammar for speaking is very good. Thank you. Do you pronounce 니은 as 이은 when it's followed by 기억? 먼 like 민한가 했는가 는가. I'm not sure about that. But not really. What's the example? Mango. Ah, no. Min mani. Wangangada. Wangang. Not really. Just 니은 and 기억. 천천히 말해주세요. Yeah, that's right. Or 천천히 말씀해주세요. That's also right. That's also nice. 천천히 말해주세요. Ah, that's good. You're welcome, Gisri. I find it more comfortable. 천천히 말해주세요. 건강하다. 건강. No, just 니은 and 기억. You find it more comfortable to say 이응. Pronounce that like 이응. But not really. 건강하다. 건강하다. Just 니은 and 기억. Yeah. 한국 만화 보기 하면 한국어를 배울 수 있을까요? 한국 만화. Korean cartoon. Korean animation. Korean cartoon. If you watch or see Korean cartoon, can you learn Korean? Yeah, I think so. I think so. When I'm learning English, I also watch some Peanuts or like Calvin and Hobbes. Those two were my favorite. I don't really read many comic books, but still. And if you learn Korean, there are many comic Korean on the internet. So I think it would be helpful to you. Okay, if you don't have question, I'll just the end today's session, and I hope you Naver Webtoon. Yeah, Naver Webtoon is, you can see many Korean comics on Naver Webtoon. That's the site. You can see many kinds of Korean comics. Calvin and Hobbes is the best. Yeah, it's really funny. It's really fun. I really enjoyed watching that. I'm not sure how helpful was this today's session. I mean, I'm trying this and that on the live streaming, and this is one of them. I'll try to think of the better way, find a better way. That's what I'm doing these days. Anyway, I'm happy to see all of you, and I hope you learn a lot during the session. People at airport usually speak English though. Yeah. But not everyone though. It'd be better to know the Korean, I think. That's what I think. Thank you, Jess, and thank you, Dongbang Minju. Okay, thank you for joining the session, and see you next time. 예, 모두들 잘 지내시고요. 예, 같이 라이브에 참여해 주셔서 감사합니다. 참여해 주셔서 감사합니다. 네, 그럼 모두들 잘 지내시고요. 네, 다음에 또 봬요. 안녕히 계세요.